Hey everybody, it's Dr. Magnifico from GRSWellVetAndPoddly.com. This is Chloe, who is actually one of our rescues. She came in to be spayed. So we just finished her spay, and she has some really, really yucky, dirty ears. Did we do the other side already?
Mm-mm.
Okay, so let me flip her over so I can show the other side. So I talk a lot about ears, and I write a lot about ears. These are really dirty. You can see kind of all the dirt down in there. When you go to the vet's office, you will see your vet doing this. We put a lot of the ear solution in. We massage it, so we work it into the ear really well. That helps break down and emulsify, and it acts like sort of, it's called saponification. So it's breaking up the dirt and the wax and everything that's kind of crusted inside that ear. The next thing you will see your vet doing is we use gauze, so we're cleaning out as much, kind of debulking as much of that gunk as we can. And then typically, the technicians or the veterinarian will use these long swabs. I go to great lengths to discourage people from using the swabs. I think in an awake patient, if you're not trained and you don't know how deep that ear canal is, it's really painful and it's very uncomfortable. And then your animals associate pain with the bad ears. So in general, you don't have to do this. We will do it at the veterinary clinic. It's just really debulk to get all that stuff out of there. And then typically we flush again, we flood the ears again, we massage again, and we work it all out. But there's a difference between what we do in the veterinary clinic and what you guys do at home. So please, if you see your vet doing this, it doesn't really kind of give you carte blanche permission to do it at home. Just stick with using your ear cleaner. The directions are on there and they're very good, but stay away from the swabs. It really just packs the dirt in there. It can hurt and you never really know how deep to go. The tympanic membrane, which is the ear membrane, is down there, and rupturing that makes, you know, is really, really bad. So even though you see your vet doing the swabs, don't do it at home. Chloe's waking up from her spay and her ears are now nice and clean. If you have any questions, you can reach us anytime at poddly.com or here at GRSWellVet. Good morning, Chloe. Okay, see you guys later. Bye.